Have you ever had a secret admirer?
Oh,
这是一个很深的一个问题。It's
quite a popular bank in school.
那我就要数一数，你要让我想一想，到底有多少个？
Maybe double digit? I think that answers the question. How has your upbringing made you to be the person you are today? My dad, when he was alive, was a super too punctual person, if you like, you know. For example, if you were saying, okay, we're going to go out at 9 o'clock, my dad would be ready by 8:30 and he would be like pushing everybody. It's like, you said 9 o'clock, you know? And I think over time, I have gone up to be like that. I get anxious if I'm late. And perhaps it's also important because suddenly now, as a priest, you cannot be late for Mass.
You know my dad? My dad is an Air Force regular. He's been a regular his whole life. When I was in my primary and secondary school, right, he was a warrant officer, right? So he was, in a way, a superior to a lot of his men. Every now and then, he would come back and he would talk about, you know, this guy in his unit has these problems, and how he would try to help them. And actually I saw that in my dad a lot, right? Trying to build his men up. I think that has really impacted the way I am today. It's not just about helping a person in the here and now, right? But how can I help a person to really grow so that at the end of the day, he or she can stand on their own 2 feet.
勤劳的人，我的第二个榜样应该是我的老姥，就是我的奶奶。我的奶奶比较虔诚，经常去教堂里面祈祷什么的，反正就在教会里面算是比较活跃的一个人，在我的信仰上，她给我立了一个榜样。
What is your mother's name? Tell me about her. Okay, so my mom's name is Helena. Well, my mom and I, we share a very close connection. We've gone a good number of travels together. So mother and son, we still hold hands when we go overseas, you know. She's the one who really keeps the family together. She's very prayerful. For her, every day, the day cannot start unless she has finished her whole stack of prayer cards. You know, she got one whole stack and she has to go right through all of them. During the difficult time when I so-called left the family to join Carmel, my dad was already on his dying bed. That very year, my dad passed on that very first year. My mom sort of lost two members, so to speak. I left the family to go to Carmel and my dad passed on that very same year. But because my mom has always been so faithful to her prayer, and I think it sustained her, and today, my mom is a very independent woman, all thanks to my mother's faithful prayer life.
What was the most memorable lesson you learned from your parents? I don't have to be serious, right? So, when I was young, I was quite a rascal. And, you know, I like to play computer games, right? My parents, they both had to work. So I'll come home, and you know, for a few hours, I'm alone. Of course, they would want me to study. Which parent wouldn't, right? And of course, I wouldn't want to study. Which child would, right? So, they caught me playing the computer games a few times when they came home. So my dad was like, you cannot play, I'm going to lock the computer. So last time the computers, they had this lock thing where you can lock the CPU and all. So he locked the computer. Following day, I spent the better part of 3 hours trying to unlock the computer. And then I finally did, and I played like 15 minutes of games before he came back and I got scolded. Obviously, he was furious. And then after that, he took away the keyboard. By that time, right, my school, you know, we had computers, so I brought home a keyboard. He did all kinds of things, lah. I just tried to trump him and I was successful. I was feeling really great about myself. But until one day, he opened the console and he took out a tiny little power fuse from the head. For the life of me, I couldn't figure out that But you know, the lesson I learned from my parents, I was going to lose to them. You can never beat them, especially when you're young.
在我生命中最大的挑战应该是属于亲情方面的，因为在我们的文化里面，在我们的家族里面，人都很注重的是传宗接代，也很注重的是你要赡养父母这些。我自己的话，可能在这方面的话，作为一个神父的话，可能没有更多的精力去照顾自己的父母。我想这个可能就是一个很大的一个挑战，将来的我也不知道。
Yeah, saying goodbye to family sort of speak was one of the greatest challenge. I can still now, as I close my eyes, remember that moment I was lying on my bed and looking at my room and my walls, and I was telling to my room, goodbye room, you know, like, what is it going to be like? You know, I'm going to uncharted territory. It was very scary. Joining the seminary, joining the religious life means really leaving your family behind. Jesus said, right, those who look back, you're not worthy of the kingdom of God. So there is that mindset that now your new family is karma. You must let go. And like I said, my dad, that point of time, he was not in the best of health. That was very tough. Very, very tough.
如何去克服呢? 我个人的经验, 在我修道的时候, 家里也发生了很多事情, 也很多的不平安, 特别是当我准备要灵洗成为一个天主教的教友的时候, 我的母亲也生病，我的父亲也工作也没有，家里感觉好像是陷入了低谷。然后我灵洗完之后，家里的很多事情都发生了很大的变化。然后我母亲学了一门新的手艺，找了一个新的一个工作，我父亲也找了一个工作。他现在工作的地方竟然是在很离一个天主教教堂很近的一个地方，然后我就很惊讶，我就觉得这个让我更加信靠天主。 你去修道，你去做我的事情，我来做你的事情，他会替我来照顾我的父母。
How did I overcome it? I guess crying, praying, that helped. And knowing also that my mom is praying back in Singapore, knowing that she hasn't given up as well, you know, all our perseverance, all our prayerfulness, we have overcome these challenges. But it wasn't easy at all.
我的爸爸是不反对也不支持，我的姐姐是比较反对的，我每年有放假期间回家的时候，他就跟我说，哎呀，不要修道了，回来吧。反正就是每年见到他的时候，他都会说这句话。我工作的期间，他说啊，那你好好工作，就不要再去了。那个时候，反正就是一直反对，到我开始上神学的时候。 才慢慢有所改变，这个改变也是感谢天主，我自己为他做的一个祈祷，就希望他能改变他的思想。现在他很支持我。
What's a heartfelt encouragement that someone has given to you to this statement that I made that I'm going to join karma? Two of my very good friends, the encouragement was, Emmanuel, don't worry, leave your parents to us. That sentence, that remark, that response, I think the Lord spoke through them to assure me that if you leave everything to God, He will take care of it. If there's one thing I could say to my dad right now, it would be my deepest regret that he was not around for my ordination. I wish I had loved him more. I was very happy that at least at his dying moments, my mom, my sis, and I were at his deathbed. We held his hands, we urged him to let go. That was a very precious thing. He really loved me, and he never stood in my way when I made a decision to join karma. And so if I see him today, I would really say thank you, and I really wish I had loved you more, and I wish that you were there for my ordination. Yeah.
Have you ever experienced a miracle in your life? So I've never had all this kind of miraculous healing and all that. But just being able to wake up every day, right? And to live life, right? The way I am living my life now. I mean, to me, it is really nothing short of a miracle.
我觉得我的人生就是一个奇迹。我是从一个无神论者，我从来不相信有神的人，然后成一个泛神论者，就是什么神都相信，然后成为一个一神论者，就是相信天主，然后做了个神父。我觉得我这个人生，我自己的经历就是一个奇迹，都不可思议的一个奇迹，我自己都没想到的一个事情怎么会发生到我的身上，觉得这就是一个奇迹。
It's a miracle also because like, this is not something that I could have ever imagined when I was younger. It really feels like a miracle to me.
What does keeping it real mean to you? What people want is to see that you are real, that you are not a facade. You know, you are someone just like them. You are someone who is frail at times. You are someone who can get angry, you know?
It is just to be honest and sincere with who you are, to be rooted in who you are as a person and your core. You know why? Because ultimately, the Lord wants to communicate. He wants to be in communion with the real you, right? And not with the personas and the masks that you put on. And actually, at the end of the day, the Lord knows who the real you is.
So keep it real. Don't fake it.
我们都知道很难的一个问题，在家庭生活中，哎，有的时候妻子会经常会问一些很奇怪的问题，会问丈夫说，如果我和你妈同时掉进河里了，你到底先救谁？那丈夫就很奇怪，这问题怎么回答？如果你和我妈掉进河里了，那如果是谁？如果是谁？我又不认识如果，为什么叫救如果呢？妻子也无言以对说，你到底说，如果我和你妈同时掉进河里，你救谁？那丈夫真的不好回答说，那你告诉我你掉哪一条河里呢，好让我去救你啊，你都不告诉我掉哪一条河，我怎么去救你？